2010 analyst Dr. Nicholas Iberol joins me every week in studio to give us his opinion on various 2010 articles that have been making the press. This week, Dr. Nick has brought a scorecard with a difference to the studio. But before we get into that, let's take a look at a promise that was made by South Africa's president, Thabo Mbeki, to FIFA president, Sepp Blatter.
I want to say to you, Mr. President, we will host in 2010 the most successful FIFA Soccer World Cup. And we'll keep that promise. Africa, Mr. President, is ready. Africa's time has come. Africa is calling. Come to Africa in 2010.
And that was the president saying the best World Cup ever. That's quite a promise. Dr. Nick, always a pleasure to have you. And it is a big promise, especially after a successful German campaign. And I wonder, is there a way that we can measure just how good this World Cup might be?
Well, the one number, Peter, that will really determine whether 2010 will be the best World Cup ever is determined by what is called the Net Promoter Score, which is really looking at the number of detractors versus the number of promoters and establishing from a visitor point of view how many visitors will go back and advocate South Africa back home.
All right. Now, I know that you've spent quite a bit of time, effort and study in developing the 2010 scorecard that you're going to take us through. Tell us about that scorecard. What does it measure and how is it going to help us assess these World Cup finals?
Well, it's basically based on President Mbeki's promise. And shortly thereafter, FIFA President Blatter said that 2006 was the best World Cup ever because, and I quote, never before has an event been delivered in such a global and emotional manner. And that is what the 2010 scorecard measures. It measures the emotional experience, not the bricks and mortar, not the stadium, not the infrastructure, the visa, the energy supply, but the experience. And fortunately, we have a lot of data from Germany that we can benchmark against.
All right, well, let's take us through that scorecard and the various criteria that you're going to be taking us through. This first one, delivering brand promise, winning host team. Tell us a little bit about some of the things that you saw there.
Well, brand promise for 2010 is Kinako, it is time, celebrate Africa's humanity. So it has been defined, it has been aligned to the logo. The question is it being translated into specific touch points that the ordinary South Africans can deliver the way that Germans delivered a time to make friends to visitors.
And how do we compare on the scorecard at the moment?
Well, at the moment, we have a score of 70%, so it's well on track. The other question is really, is a brand promise, celebrate Africa's humanity, being communicated to prospective visitors in an engaging manner to attract as many visitors as possible in 2010?
All right. Okay, so that's delivering brand promise. Let's move on to some of the others. Perhaps winning host team. What does that measure and how are we doing there?
Well, that really measures the prospects of Bafana Bafana becoming a winning team in 2010, which is critical.
Yeah.
It is critical for galvanizing the nation. It is critical for uplifting the collective energy. And one of the criteria is whether a compelling and clear vision has been declared for Bafana Bafana. Now there we have contradictory statements. Pereira spoke about forming a competitive team. Once he spoke about winning the World Cup, then FIFA has made it very clear that they expect Bafana Bafana to advance to the quarterfinals at least. And Santana has been silent. And we need to get a clear vision for Bafana Bafana.
What does it mean if we don't progress?
It basically means that soccer supporters will shift their allegiance to probably another African team. And it will make the difference between having a good and a great World Cup.
All right, okay, let's move on to other criteria. Perhaps let's move on to this number four, gender equality.
Well, being the Women's Month, this is a very important component, which is many times overlooked, because at the previous World Cup, the amount of spectators at the fan festivals, 45% of them were women. And women's soccer is now the fastest growing sport in the world. In many parts of the world, for example, Afghanistan, they're establishing national teams, establishing a league, and it serves as a catalyst for gender equality and female participation in all walks of life.
And how are we doing in South Africa?
Well, there is room to catch up. There's also room to catch up for Banyana Banyana, the women's team, who were one of the top African teams in the early 2000s and have now slipped and lost sponsorships. So we need to rally the nation around Banyana Banyana.
All right, let's chat about visitor safety, because I think a lot of press has been had abroad about safety in South Africa. What's the score and how do you measure?
Well, the score is obviously fairly low. The score measures perception. It measures the perception of South Africa as a safe destination domestically and overseas, both from a prospective visitor's point of view and from the media. And that's obviously, now you have to remember that prospective visitors do their bookings about a year in advance, which is going to be around June, July 2009, at the time of the Confederations Cup, which is a unique opportunity to showcase South Africa as a safe destination.
Now, I know you've got in total sort of 10 criteria, but let's perhaps the last one we look at this week, nation building, because that's quite an important one in terms of having a World Cup finals, isn't it? Is the ability to get a nation together.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm. And that's what it did in Germany. It united the nation, East and West. It turned out to be a catalyst for purging the negative feelings of the past, for purging the negative feelings of guilt. It elevated the nation pride index by 12 percentage points, which was significant. And hopefully that is what it will do in 2010. It will move our focus on the common goal and away from the differences that keep us apart.
And what's the score at the moment for?
The total score is 38%.
Right.
And if you wish to have a closer look at the criteria, please go to www.2010scorecard.com.
All right, so we'll certainly keep a keen eye on that one. Dr. Nick, as always, a pleasure talking to you.
Thanks, Peter.